Hey guys, Dave here from Sonic Orb Studios, and it's time for another episode of Your Questions Answered right here on Sonic Orb Studios Network channel. So, a member of mine asked from YouTube, what is the deal with routing audio, the in and out points, pre and post fader, and all that fun stuff in the program known as Reaper? Well, it comes natural to some people, as I told them in a quick message, and it may be really difficult for others. I think it's more difficult these days, being that there's so many different ways you can route audio with digital hardware mixers, and even more so with the software mixers such as these, with the software on your computer. So I figured I'd go over the details by showing you what each setting does here. So we got this track here. We'll say we like that mix right there, but we also want to make another submix. Why would we want to do that? Well, let's say we want to send the master out to a recording device, and we want to set that up so it's proper levels and everything. We've got the perfect mix for that. But then there's also someone in studio who wants to listen with their own separate mix. Maybe they want a little bit less of this or a little bit less reverb on something else. We can easily do that by creating a bus and sending that second bus or sub out, if you will, to his headphone amplifier, and he can adjust his levels with the hardware device, but we can also adjust the mix itself. So let's actually start off by adding an effect here. We'll say, hey, after this effect, we'd like the final mix here. So it's a really deep effect, just to demonstrate our levels here and what it sounds like. But you'll notice we're averaging around negative 6 dB. That's where we want to keep it, and we'll continue on from there. So we have to create a bus output. Now in Reaper, you can go into track and try to look for new buses and all that, but the reality is, for whatever reason, that they don't have an actual bus. You can open up templates and all that, but in order to create an output bus or a submix, if you will, you have to create a new track, and you can title that, say, Bus A. And say we'll make this go out to headphones. So I'm trying to see, I don't think there's a way to actually, probably not. I was trying to see if there was a way to actually, adjust the width of these tracks down here. Doesn't seem to be a way to do that, but either way, you can see bus A is our headphone out. If we hover over it, we could see that as well. So we have track 1 and track 2. So we like the way track 1 sounds. We want to send that to recorder, but we also want to send output at some point to bus A for a headphone mix. So we hit the IO button here, and it brings up a new window. This allows you to actually adjust the levels yet again, or you can also send out to, say, like a hardware output. Say if you have a sound card with multiple outputs, like the Presonus FP10, you could easily route there too, but it doesn't give you many options as routing in the sends here. So we're going to go to our headphone send bus A. And you'll notice it adds a new window here underneath. And it's not really well laid out. I can see why some people get confused with this, but hey, we're going to deal with it here and go through. You have the ability to adjust the levels. Scroll over left here. This is not affecting the track level. It's affecting just the send. Now, where is the send getting audio from? Well, at this point, you have the ability to say where. You can get it post-fader, pre-fader, or pre-effect. What's the difference? Well, let me demonstrate each one. Post fader is going to take the audio signal after the fader. It's going to come in, it's going to hit its EQ, it's going to hit its effects, it's going to hit its panning, and then it's going to hit its master level here, and then it's going to go to our output. So we can demonstrate that right now, closing this down, and we'll solo our headphone mix. We could turn down our headphone mix, that's great. Maybe we want it over here somewhere. But we can also turn down the original. Notice when we turn down the original though, that it affects the level of the headphone mix. Maybe we want to bypass that. As I said before, maybe we want this to be exactly around -6, like this right now. But we want to also adjust this one independently. So maybe we said maybe -6 is too hot. We're going to drop down to -12. Well, that's going to affect the headphone mix. So we want to bypass this actual fader and sometimes even the panning too. So we go back to our routing here with the I/O button and we could choose pre-fader. This is going to send the signal to the EQ, to the effect. In this case, the effect is the EQ and all that. It's going to send it through panning too, I believe, but it's going to bypass the main fader here. So if we play this back one more time, and we adjust the level down to, say, -12 or even -24, you'll notice the mix that we have that we're listening to stays exactly the same. We can even shut off this master to the recorder and still get that headphone mix. So it's a way of routing to the point where you have a lot more control. Now let's say you wanted to send a dry run out for whatever reason. Maybe your computer's lagging a little bit. It doesn't have the ability to play back and route the effects. Well, once again, you can go back in here and say send this pre-effects. So you're only going to get the dry signal to the headphone mix here. Now if we solo our first channel, it still has the effect. But as soon as it sends out to bus A for a headphone mix, you'll notice that it only has the dry signal, the original signal that was on the track. And that's pretty much it, guys. I know it's a little bit confusing when it comes to routing in a digital world. It's really easy for some people and really hard for others. The same member also had a question about MIDI editing in the program known as Reaper here. But the truth is, I really don't know much about MIDI in this program at all, and so I'm not going to go over it. But if you guys need some help on any of the things we've gone over, feel free to go up to the help here at the top panel and go under documentation. There is a download for the user's guide online for free. There's also a few books and quick start media. The Wikipedia article has a lot of information on each thing too. Great set of online manuals right there to get you started. So with that said, guys, I'm Dave from Sonic Orb Studios. Stay tuned for more great videos coming out real soon. And until that time, I'm out of here. See you then.